My name is Helen Sartorelli Dippolito.
Where did you live when World War II started?
In Corey Avenue, Braddock, PA.
How old were you at that time?
16.
What were you doing when you first heard the news of the attack on Pearl Harbor?
Coming out of church, and a couple of boys run up to us and told us that Pearl Harbor was bombed. We were all shocked and crying.
Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy. The United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan.
How did the war change your everyday life?
Well, there was a lot of things that we couldn't buy. You couldn't get gasoline. Sugar was rationed. A lot of people, sugar and butter and a lot of different things. And coffee, gosh, everybody went crazy for coffee.
What can you tell me about the air raids?
Well, the air raids were frightening. We had not so much in the daytime, but in the nighttime, boy, I'll tell you, everybody ran like heck home and make sure we put up the curtains, dark things on the doors, and we were all afraid. We took it seriously.
Ways that people supported the war effort.
Well, we bought bonds. Everybody that worked always bought bonds. When we would go to the movies, that's where our television was, the movie theaters. And before the show would start, it would have been about 20, 30 minutes of newsreel. It was enough to make you cry. And then they'd show some of the camps, and the kids used to want to see if their friends or boyfriends were there. But there was about 15 of us at all. We had a lot of fun. The girls, the two girls had cars, and they used to take us, they'd save the gas and take us to Ligonier and different places like that. That was only on some weekends.
Did you and your friends sometimes take the trolley into
We always took the trolley into Pittsburgh, and you had to take two trolleys to get into Pittsburgh, and then you had to get off one and get another trolley to get into Pittsburgh.
Okay,
well, we'd go to the ball games once in a while, but we've seen a lot of shows and stage plays. Kennywood Park, a lot of times we went on Sundays at Kennywood Park, because they always had stage shows, and there'd be big-name bands. We'd go to some of the pools, like Rainbow Garden pools and Kennywood Park pools.
How often did you write your sweetheart?
Every day. Every day I'd write something to him as if he was sitting by me, and it was like a conversation with him being there.
How often did he get to come home on leave?
Well, I got the longest that I didn't see him was 9 months when he was sent to Los Angeles. We always helped one another. That was great working with these girls. I'll tell you, there was none. We had a lot of fun. We had one girl, Shirley, she joined the Waves. Our girls, we kept in contact. Every year, they would go to one person house. Some of them moved away further and had too many kids. We were going to have picnics, but just couldn't get together anymore. But we always sent cards.
Did some of the women get married while they were working at
West? No, you weren't allowed. If you got married, you had to, well, if your husband was in the service, that's okay. But if he was out of the service, you couldn't work at the Westinghouse.
So married women weren't permitted to work?
No, unless their husband was in the service.